решили прец народный той ногти, во тебе он духа да обновим, и сострена. Remember Project presents Belene Forced Labor Camp, Bulgaria. The largest forced labor camp in Bulgaria opened in 1949 on the island of Persin, near the Danube town of Belene. With several interruptions, the camp operated until 1987. This is one of the most sinister communist camps in Eastern Europe. More than 15,000 people were sent here, most of them without clear guilt, without a legal trial or a sentence, and without documentary traces. The Belene forced labor camp is part of the system of forced labor camps in Bulgaria, through which between 30,000 and 40,000 people were incarcerated. The Belene camp was for men only. The women's camp was located on the neighboring cricket island. The inmates were brought to the train station at night in a horse wagon. They passed the outskirts of the town of Belene and got to the island over the floating. Many of the prisoners were forced to go through swamps and bushes off the road. It took them several days to pass the 10 kilometers leading to the camp. In the mud, they lost not only their clothes and shoes, but also the hope that they would ever see their loved ones again. The camp was located in a swampy area, which was often flooded by the Danube River. The inmates lived in huts made of hedge and mud, which were often flooded. These drawings were made by Krum Hurozov, who survived more than 11 years in various concentration camps in the country. In 1949, about 2,800 former political opposition activists, fascists, capitalists, and Tsarist officers were sent to the camp. These portraits of people imprisoned in the camp were secretly drawn by Peter Baichev, who spent about 5 years in the camp. Many of the inmates did not live to see their release. In 1951, an order was issued not to return the dead bodies to the families. The corpses were buried in shallow trenches along the river. Many of the bodies were dug up by wild boars, others were carried away by the current. The opponents of the communist dictatorship lived here under inhumane conditions. They were subjected to daily physical labor with unachievable production quotas and in the constant presence of armed guards. They were stuck in dugouts and hunts built by them with materials at hand. Still, the most terrible thing at the camp was hunger. After a short closure of the camp after Stalin's death, 1953, during the Hungarian Revolution in 1956, a new order was issued. To intern the most dangerous enemies to the order and security of the country, who have settled in Sofia and other major cities in TVO, Labor Educational Dormitory, Belene. In 1958, the party announced the so-called hooligans' action. In order to strengthen the fight against frequent hooliganism, we consider it appropriate to organize the introduction of forced physical labor to outspoken and harmful to the public hooligans, thieves, recidivists, and other rotten elements, shows documents from the meeting of the Politburo. In the picture you see the building in which young people were imprisoned during the hooligan period in 1958-1959. Young people just liked Western music, fashion, and wanted to think freely. That was enough to be categorized as a rotten element. According to the communist government, wearing this coat, which the militia calls yumurluk, is an act of hooliganism. In January and February of 1958, 1,400 men and 250 women of those hooligans were imprisoned in Belene camp. In the same period, a lot of priests, architects, lawyers, and all kinds of educated people, inconvenient to the authorities, were sent to the camp. Most were imprisoned without a legal trial or sentence, and without knowing what they were accused of. They were not allowed any visitors. In many cases, their families did not even know why their loved ones were imprisoned in Belene. The totalitarian state defended its authority through fear and reparations.
In August 1959, after numerous publications in Western media, the Politburo of the Central Committee of the Bulgarian Communist Party decided to close Belene camp. Although it was officially closed in 1959, it continued to function as a correctional facility for political prisoners till 1977, and probably sporadically until 1981. In 1985, more than 450 Bulgarian citizens were sent here. Mainly from Turkish descent, they were arrested for resisting the communist regime campaign of 1984 to forcibly change their Turkish names to Bulgarian ones. Among the interned were also Pomaks, Bulgarian-speaking Muslims, and 14 Bulgarian Christians. In April of 1986, the prisoners started a hunger strike which lasted 30 days. During the first days of May 1986, most of the camp's inmates were released and exiled to various regions of the country. After the collapse of the communist regime in Bulgaria in 1989, the Belene camp became a place of remembrance of the victims of the totalitarian regime of the Bulgarian Communist Party. The Belene Commemoration Day is becoming a traditional event. Since the first commemoration of the victims of the Persin Island in April of 1990, it has become a traditional annual event that brings people together from all over the country and abroad. At the beginning of the 21st century, at the initiative of the repressed farmers, the construction of a monument began, which still remains unfinished. With its many initiatives, the Belene Island Foundation works to create a memorial on the site of the camp and pass its history on to the next generation.